Who is the bad guy in history? Who isn't actually a bad guy? More so sports history, but the film Cinderella Man portrayed boxer Maximum Bayer as a murderous psychopath who gladly killed two fighters in the ring. In reality, he was personally devastated by these deaths. In the one he was most directly responsible for, he ended up giving his winnings from his next few fights to the fighter's family. Despite what was portrayed in *AMADEUS*, and though in reality they were musical rivals, Antonio Salieri was actually friends with Wolfgang Mozart. In fact, years after Mozart's death, Salieri assisted with and helped finance his son Franz Xaver's musical education as a tribute to his late friend. Machiavelli would be shocked and saddened to know his name is synonymous with tyranny and pure evil. Guy was a staunch supporter of republics and a savvy politician. Darius III and Xerxes. They are portrayed badly because of Alexander the Great and also the movie 300. Prince John. The bad guy from Robin Hood was basically the steward of a kingdom his beloved brother hadn't even set foot on. While Richard the Lionheart was faffing about in the Crusades, John was running the kingdom and turning it into something that could sustain itself. While he was doing that, his useless brother gets his ass kidnapped, so John has to raise taxes, cue Robin Hood, to bring back the rightful king the people loved so much. So basically, Prince John runs England for his brother and people love his brother for it. Then said brother gets kidnapped, so John raises taxes to get him back, and becomes the bad guy in the eyes of the lords, and by extension the people, who want their rightful king back. The man eventually does become the rightful king, only to have all the lords hate him for the crime of investing money into the kingdom. As a result, he signs the Magna Carta, limiting royal power. *THAT said he wasn't a saint. The man did have a hand in the collapse of Norman France, and wasted a lot of money and men trying to reclaim the region. I'm not trying to say he was a good guy per se, just not the bad guy for what people hate him for. That Roman that gave Jesus vinegar to drink. Turns out that the Roman military gave their soldiers the water/vinegar mix to drink as it was good for refilling salt levels after sweating. That means all the Roman did was give Jesus a sip of his own drink, not force him to drink vinegar as punishment/insult. My dad apparently, because every time we talk it's always. Buddy IDK, why you think I'm the bad guy? A more modern example is the lady that famously sued McDonald's for their coffee being too hot in 1994. That lawsuit gets treated as an example of how oversaturated America is with litigation over small things. As it turns out, however, her situation was extremely justified. She suffered third-degree burns that required skin grafting and had permanent disfigurement. Her labia fused together. Needless to say, McDonald's was serving their coffee far too hot and the case very well may have prevented future similar incidents. Edit, to the people saying it's her fault for spilling her coffee, here's a picture of her injuries, NSFW and NSFL. Does anybody really deserve those injuries for the simple mistake of spilling their coffee? Would you really expect third-degree burns if you spilled coffee on yourself? The Roman Emperor Gaius Caesar, better known as Caligula. Hell of a smear campaign his enemies did, most likely brought upon himself because of his intolerance to the Senate's corruption and or lack of effectiveness. The crazy stories, most likely made up, or were willful misrepresentation of something Caligula said. The story about him making his horse consul because he was crazy, misrepresentation of him mocking the Senate by telling them his horse could do a better job. Neville Chamberlain was widely hated in the UK after the Britain went to war with Germany because of his policy of appeasement towards the Nazi-run Germany when he was Prime Minister, even being one of the central people who allowed Germany to annex Czechoslovakia, which blew up in his face when the Germans invaded Poland and triggered the Second World War. He was forced to resign as Prime Minister less than a year into the war due to revolt from the Labour and Liberal parties, and handed the reins over to Winston Churchill, who was himself forced out of office after the First War because of fears that Germany would rearm. However, due to British laws about disclosing classified documents 30 years after their being sealed, it emerged that Britain couldn't risk Germany's anger during the Czech debacle as they were thoroughly unprepared for war. Chamberlain delayed the inevitable, which gave the Allies a significant helping hand when the war finally did happen. Richard III. He's just such a nice guy. Elizabeth Bathory. Some scholars say that the truth of the claims made against her can't be verified or debunked at this point, but there's good reason to believe that her being painted as a mass murderer was part of a smear campaign and political plot to usurp her land and power, since she was from an extremely powerful family tied to Polish royalty and the King of Hungary owed a large debt to the Bathory family, which was cancelled in exchange for not putting her on trial. Anyone who won a war then rewrote history books. Except Japan. They lost and still rewrote the history books for their own students. Marie Antoinette. The woman was a spoiled rich girl, sure, but the whole damn country condemned her despite the fact her husband was and always had been the one in charge of things. Spain. Got blamed for the 1918 pandemic because they were the only country honestly reporting on it. Other countries did not want to look weak during WWI and wouldn't report on it. Turned out that a farm in Kansas and possibly the French trenches were the actual origin. Edit. Chinese laborers locked in boxcars in Canada seems to be the current leading theory. In the new report, Humphreys finds archival evidence that a respiratory illness that struck northern China in November 1917 was identified a year later by Chinese health officials as identical to the Spanish flu. He also found medical records indicating that more than 3,000 of the 25,000 Chinese labor corps workers who were transported across Canada en route to Europe starting in 1917 ended up in medical quarantine, many with flu-like symptoms. Medusa. Cinderella Man's maximum bear. His antagonistic role was just for the film. He felt awful for killing his opponents. He also apparently funded the building of a bridge, the name of it escapes me though. Isn't necessarily a bad guy, but Ulysses S. Grant. His presidency is known for being pretty crummy, but the truth is that he had no experience in politics and was easily manipulated. Corruption was rampant under his presidency because people took advantage of how he saw the best in people. He was a great general that was essential in the Civil War, but was also smeared throughout his life. Lost causes labeled him as a butcher and a drunk, when the truth is that he really just did the best job he could. Although he did have a problem with alcohol, it was greatly exaggerated. Not really a bad guy, but Reddit has a tendency to judge medieval/earlier innocental famous people as pedophile because they married their wife after the first blood, but at the time the average age for a girl to menstruate was more 16 to 17, so they weren't fucking 12, yo. Also, it was common among kings to marry legally to forge an alliance, but to not really live as a couple since many years after. So even if King X really did marry a 13 years old, there is a very good chance that for a good 5 years they didn't even use the same room. Does Hades count? Cause if so, it's Hades. He's actually a really good guy. He's a loving husband and, to be frank, a very peaceful god. The only time he tormented someone was when two guys tried to steal his wife, Persephone. Sorry if I spelt that wrong. Vlad the Impaler. The man used over-the-top gore and extremely messed up ways to defend his much smaller country from those who tried take it over. He ended the tradition of having to turn over the firstborn sons to the invading forces in return for peace. Sure, he used some insanely brutal tactics, but they sent a message that made both him and his army seem otherworldly. The Persians, who are villainized by the Greeks, but are actually one of the most culturally and technologically advanced cultures of the time. Heinz Doofenshmirtz. Not necessarily perceived as a bad guy, but First Officer William Murdoch of the Titanic gets a bad rep from the movie. He did not shoot people then kill himself. He was actually a hero and saved many lives. His family was upset with how he was portrayed. It depends on the point of view. On Russians, mind Mikhail Gorbachev is a bad guy because they make him responsible for the end of the Soviet Union. Vlad the Impaler. Dr. Doofenshmirtz. This isn't exactly historical, but the lady who sued McDonald's because she spilled hot coffee on herself. She actually suffered third-degree burns and really only wanted McDonald's to cover her medical expenses. When they refused, she ended up having no choice but to sue, and she won. McDonald's then launched a misinformation campaign to make it seem like the lawsuit was totally frivolous and basically humiliate her. Benedict Arnold. Now, he was a traitor, that's undeniable. But he fought for the colonists earnestly at the beginning of the revolution, but kept having other people taking credit for the battles he was involved in, and was finally accused of being sympathetic to the British because of the social circles he was involved in. This was after he had been wounded twice in battle, and I believe he also lost his civilian business. Basically, he got shit on throughout the revolution by his own side, and eventually got sick of it and switched sides. Still a traitor, or a double traitor, since was technically a traitor to the British first, but it didn't happen for no reason. Jack Kevorkian. He was a doctor who was way ahead of his time. By supporting people's right to choose to end their own suffering, he is often portrayed as a murder crazy psycho, when in reality he only wanted to give people the right to die with dignity and grace. I'm hoping that as the shift for people's right to die becomes more accept, history will rewrite the chapter on him. I want to say Alan Turing, who despite all his work, was essentially mutilated and made a black mark on UK history for being gay. Squidward. Medusa. In my opinion, she was the victim